Hello everyone, nice that you are watching my video on stakeholders. We focus on an analytical approach to complex situations. These situations could be anything from improvements of existing production processes in the clothing industry to strategic market development studies for a new brand of beer or a classic consultancy question on a merger of two companies that also have to combine their client ordering system. Most elementary characteristic of a complex situation is that there is no way to find the best answer, the single right solution, or the correct way to do it. In our analytical approach to dealing with these kind of complex situations, one of the first things we do is using the perspective of many different stakeholders involved in your complex situation. Their ideas and experiences within that complex situation help us as they enrich our ideas of that situation. Also, their ideas for changes, system interventions, or solutions to existing problems in that situation help us to consider a variety of options rather than focusing on one only. That last thing, focusing on one idea to change the situation or one particular solution for a complex problem, is very natural to people in general. As soon as we want to change something, we focus on the first idea that seems to be good enough. And from that moment on, we selectively collect arguments why our idea is so good. We even defend our idea against the ideas of others. Well, that is clear what happens then. A lot of discussion, delay in decision making. Maybe the strongest person puts his idea through, or the person that shouts the loudest, or the one that knows best how to influence colleagues in a company or influence public opinion in society. Just as it is very useful to know how these kind of power and influence mechanisms work, it's also very useful to have the advantages of a systematic approach, which is what we do, as it gives you a good overview and it structures the situation. By applying it, chances increase that you take better decisions and get more support for that decision from the stakeholders involved. I will help you now with the identification of those stakeholders in your complex situation that, so to say, matter. And from these stakeholders, we more clearly can identify what the situation looks like using the dilemmatic perspective on the complex situation. Only after we focus on what our own role is in the situation and whom we need in order to either change our situation or solve our problem. But first, the stakeholders. You already might have given the perspective of some people some thought, but let's do it more elaborate here. First, try to enlarge your list of possible stakeholders and make it as long as you can. Include persons, but also organized groups such as departments, teams, pressure groups, and also include whole organizations, governmental institutions, and so on. Try to make them as clear as possible. Things like the government or society are far too vague. Whom are you going to talk to if you want to know what society thinks of it? So mention a clear group in society that has explicit ideas. Mention directors at a ministry or even the minister herself. Then give each of these stakeholders a place in the following grid. The vertical axis is the amount of power these stakeholders have in your complex situation. That is, to what extent are they capable of making changes, making system interventions in that complex situation? It is much more likely that a minister can influence the expansion ideas of an airport than that a single protester at the gate of the airport shouts, "No expansion because I can't sleep at night anymore to do the noise." This doesn't say anything about who is right or wrong, if anyone is, but about the level of influence certain stakeholders have. The horizontal axis is about the level of interest these stakeholders have in the complex situation. If they don't care about it, they can have a lot of power in that situation, but still nothing will happen. The people that you need are the people in the right upper corner, stakeholders who have both power and interest. They can make system interventions and they are motivated to do so. Now, where do you put yourself? That's an interesting question. If you are in the right upper corner, you can consider yourself to own, to a certain extent, your complex problem. You have the power to change it and you have the interest. If you, however, did not put yourself in the upper right corner but still want to change the current complex situation that you are facing, you need to think about bonding with stakeholders in that corner. Make coalitions, look for ways to cooperate, and so on. And as always, this is what we are going to exercise this week. I have a quiz for you in which you have the possibility to rethink the ideas that are introduced in this video more elaborately, then try out and apply it to your own case. Maybe leave the quiz open, as I'm sure that during the application all kinds of questions pop up in your mind that I cover in the quiz. After your application, I share with you the most common pitfalls I've seen when people apply the idea of stakeholders and the power interest grid. It is a practical way to have another critical look at your work and make some improvements to make it more useful for you. Good luck and enjoy the application, and I see you in the next video.